I need you to have a Bible on your phone. God, send any messages! God! Who would ever decline God? I would never decline God.
Right?
Man, God damn!
Okay. What's up, y'all? It's your girl Sang, and today we're gonna be reacting to a video from Christ Forgiveness titled David Lynn Confronts I Show Speed. Are you a Christian? Based on that intro, I don't really know. He used the Lord's name in vain. I don't think he is, but we're gonna find out for ourselves. So let's go ahead and get into it.
Like, I'm about to go see my idol, bro. Like, I'm about to go see the person that I love the most, bro. Like, I'm about to go see the person that I look up to every day. I'm about to go see the person that I watch his highlights every day, bro. Cristiano freaking Ronaldo, bro.
No evolutionist can tell us why there are still monkeys today if we evolved from monkeys. Why are there still monkeys today?
I'm a monkey!
No, you're not.
You just called me a monkey!
Charles Darwin says you're a monkey.
What?
Charles Darwin calls you a monkey.
Oh,
shit.
Tell us,
I want to ask you.
All right, if you guys don't know who I Show Speed is, it's like a really young kid. I think he's like 19. If I'm wrong, he's somewhere around there. He's like super young. So him cracking jokes and stuff like this, on par for somebody of his brand. He's a super big streamer as well. So he's very famous off of, like, doing stuff like this, pretty much. I'm too old. Like, his content doesn't entice me, but I just wanted to give you guys quick backstory on who this is.
I want to ask you something, man.
Yeah, ask me something.
Tell him. Because I watch your videos, man. I actually made a review of one of your videos.
All right, what is it?
So I forgot what it's called, but you made a video. I want to know, man. Are you gay?
Yo, we can't be gay, bro.
Only for Ronaldo.
I will say this generation is kind of weird. Like, when I was growing up, if you were a man and you happened to say something that sounded kind of gay or fruity, you would be like, no homo or pause, something of that nature. This generation, however, leans into that like super hard. You have him saying stuff like this. Gideon used to do the homosexual thing. Also really weird. He claims he got rid of that and don't do that no more, because he was questioned about that before, because he says he's Christian. Hard to tell, because I've seen a few of his videos, and his videos, it'd be like, for real, you're a Christian? Okay, I guess. But I've also seen him on panels, like on Destiny's channel, and talking with Abba from Abba and Preach, and he seems like a completely different person. So it has to just be a character. And then you got Aiden Ross, who like really leans into like being gay. And then if somebody be like, oh, you gay, bro? He'd be like, no, I'm not gay, I'm straight. It's like, well, what do you expect somebody to think? You really lean hard into that, the whole gay thing. It's weird for a straight man. This whole generation does that. It's so weird.
All right, come. Listen, hold that for a second. Hold on, I want to ask you something, man.
What?
Listen, man, I know your father is a Christian.
Okay.
Oh, is he?
Are you a Christian?
Am I a Christian? Okay. See, that's a very, you know, great question, you know what I'm saying? But let me ask you this.
No. Answer the question first. It's okay. A great question. Because a Christian is someone that's repented of their sins.
Why you always here?
That doesn't support sexual immorality. That's not walking for fame, but living for Jesus. Someone who's denied themselves. Pick up their cross daily and follow me. I'm not against you trying to make money
or making good music.
But if you're a Christian, you need to repent of your sins. Otherwise, just like any person here, not just you, You'll find yourself in hell.
All right, okay, hold on.
So are you a Christian?
Hey, let me talk, all right?
Are you a Christian?
Okay, first of all, I came here to see Ronaldo. I'm in Manchester right now. You're asking me questions about God, okay? You know, I love...
Well, to be fair, you came over there first. They didn't seek you out to ask you questions about God. You came over there first trying to be funny and ruining what the guy was doing. Because you all remember, it was a different guy preaching before he took this mic. So, bro, nobody was bothering you. You were bothering them.
Love God, you know, but...
Hey, I want to know.
Hey, okay. Yeah, let me tell you this. Stop talking to me, sir. Have a nice day.
I thought so.
That's... What? Hold on, did I miss something when I was talking? We're going to go back just a slightly smidge. A slight smidge.
God, okay? You know, I love God, you know, but...
Just if
you... Hey.
I want to know.
Hey, okay. Yeah, let me tell you this. Stop talking to me, sir. Have a nice day.
I thought so.
So he couldn't answer the question. That's wild, because if you're Christian, it's yes or no. It's not complicated. It's not hard. You don't have to sit there and go through all of that just to be like, stop talking to me and walk off. Just say you are or you aren't. It's that easy. If somebody was to come press me, hey, are you Christian? Yep, sure am. Now, if I'm doing something they don't like, they'd be like, well, I don't understand how you could say that. And you're like, we would just sit there and go back and forth. Now, he was on his way to a soccer event. But like I said, he bothered them first. So to act like you didn't have time to do all this, you shouldn't have been over there bothering them to begin with. But to deny Jesus and God and all that in front of everybody is wild. It is wild. He's definitely chose his fame and everything over this. That's wild.
I thought so. The man is gay for Ronaldo. His father's a Christian, and he's afraid to acknowledge the question because he knows what I'm saying is right. He's going against his conscience. He loves his fame, and he loves the world more than he loves God. He loves the fame, and he loves the money more than he loves God. And he'll be gay for another man. You've heard it from his own lips. I'm here to tell you today, unless you repent, you will perish and find your way in hell. All fornicators, all those who sell their soul for money, for fame, and living in sodomite, effeminate lifestyles will find themselves in hell. It doesn't matter how famous you are or not. When you sell your soul for fame and for a following, you're not going to have that in hell. It's going to fade away. This is why it's important to look at God and your soul and where you are with Him. Jesus said, unless a man repents, he will perish. He will perish. What? I forgot that guy's name. What was his name? I Show Speed. He sped away very quickly when the truth of Jesus Christ was mentioned. Why couldn't he answer the question whether he was a Christian? Why was he so quick to acknowledge, or rather affirm, that he could be gay for another man? You see, this man makes provocative videos, they say, for the attention, for whatever it is. His father's a Christian, and he knows what the question was, and he could not answer it.
Because I don't think he's a Christian. You keep saying his father's Christian. That means nothing. I know many of people that grew up in religious households and became adults and are not religious at all. Hopefully, like, they can make their way back to it. And I'm not even just speaking on Christianity at this point. I'm talking about people, no matter what your household preaches. If your parents push it on you too hard, or like most young people, like, ah, it's boring, I'm not doing this. Because it's not fun. The world is fun, right? You can do whatever you want. You do crazy debauchery, like, what do you say, provocative things. It's fun, it's awesome, right? That's how we look at it when we're younger. At some point as you grow older, either you move away from that and you be like, oh man, my parents was kind of right. Let me go back to doing what we were doing. Or you just stay in it. That's usually just how it goes. I think a good example from a TV show for this is, I think it's on Hulu, it's called Rami. They practiced Islam. His family were Muslims. They came to America. Coming to America, they fell into the American ways and they stopped praying. What did they pray, like 5 times a day or something? They stopped doing all of that. And Rami was a mess. He couldn't get his life together for anything. Finally, it takes all this chaos and stuff happening. You get to like the ending scene of this past season where it finally hits him and he was like, I was never supposed to do this. I'm supposed to be religious. And he like He looks at his watch, notices what time it is, and he runs down to the beach, takes his shoes off, washes his feet, and he just starts praying. In that same sequence, his family is back at home. They realize they done messed up and they gotta get their life together. They put on, they lay down the robes, the women put the garments on, and they are all praying together. It's usually just what happens. Like, and that's just an example from like a TV show, but I've seen it in reality. For it don't matter what religion the kid is, like, they'll leave, and at some point, if they really want to, or like if they're Christian, the Holy Spirit calls them back, or whatever, they'll come back. I show Speed is young. He's gonna do what he wants right now, and he's made millions of dollars doing things on like Twitch and YouTube and stuff. He's loving the world right now. If he comes back, it's gonna be a while before he ever comes back. I promise you.
He had to run. Because the Bible says light comes into the world. Men loves darkness rather than light for fear that their deeds will be known. They would rather stay in the dark than into the light. We got to pray for I Show Speed and all the people. We got to pray because they're trading their soul. The Bible says, what will a man give in exchange for their soul? What will you give in exchange for your soul? A little crowd following you around being gay for Ronaldo? Will you sell your soul for a soccer icon, a football icon? You're going to sell your soul for that? You're going to sell your soul for a 20 little kids, teeny boppers running around? Hey, I'm around, I show speed. Is that what you're going to sell your soul for?
Yeah, that's what you're
going to sell your soul for. A Mercedes-Benz, a house? What will you sell your soul for? If you're a young person today and you're listening, you got to turn off I Show Speed and make yourself available and run with speed to Jesus Christ. You need to use speed to go to Jesus Christ. Run for your life, because Jesus Christ is coming soon, and he's coming like a thief in the night. So whoever you are, young or old, rich or poor. What was that? I can't even hear you, bro. Come here. Sorry.
Speed's a young kid who's made millions, you know. So who are you to say that's wrong?
Yeah.
This guy wasn't listening at all. There's nothing wrong. Here's the thing. If we are all, I'm Christian, so I'm just going to assume everybody else watching this is Christian. We can be rich, like we can have money. How we go about that though is very different from how an unbeliever goes about that. Everything Speed does, if I was to look at him and his content, I'd be like, oh yeah, there's no way he's Christian, no way at all. And I would be right, because he, in this video, he couldn't even say yes or no if he was or wasn't. Because if you are, you just gonna say, you're gonna be like, yeah, I'm Christian. But he was embarrassed to say he wasn't, because he knows what it is. Right? But he also likes his money and his stuff. He's living amongst the world. I don't know what part this guy came in. It's like nobody's telling him he has to be broke. And David Lynn said that in the beginning. He's like, I don't care that you have money. It's how you go about getting the money. That's the difference.
Yeah, you know, nothing's wrong with making millions. It's just said what will you make millions doing? Selling your soul to the devil or honoring God? You can trade your soul for millions. Absolutely. You can trade your soul for a prostitute today. But where will you be if you were to die tomorrow? And do you even care?
Exactly.
You say he sold his soul. He hasn't sold his soul. He's just a very funny guy who's done well for himself. So, you know, we'll leave it at that. Just respect. Well,
he definitely sold his soul. He don't understand. The devil runs this realm we are all in right now. So it is very easy to succumb to all the things that he put out there for us to love and want. When I tell y'all, ever since I was already a pretty minimalistic person prior to becoming Christian, even that took like a while for me to get into. Since becoming Christian, I do not care for anything. Like, seriously, on a materialistic level, I care for nothing, zero. Like, I don't think he gets that. This guy can't be religious on any front to not get what this guy is saying. You know what I like doing? I like doing Christian videos and putting them up for y'all. I don't get paid for this. I'm not monetized. I haven't even cleared that threshold yet. And the day I ever do, cool, I guess. My plans is to keep doing what we're already doing with the money that's in-house. Make sure the bills stay paid, save, invest, work towards getting a business off the ground. That's about it. That's same thing we've always done. I don't care. You can sit here tomorrow and be like, oh yeah, my goal, I gotta get these videos out because I just gotta get this NSX, I gotta get this car, ooh. I don't care about any of that. I've already made up in my mind too that I'm a, once checks start coming, however much they may be, I'm gonna give a portion of that away. Now I have to be very thorough on what charity I'm giving that money away to, because a lot of charities are scams. We all know that. So I need to be very careful. I need to find, I was thinking about finding somebody like right here in my city where I can see the work being done in front of my eyes. Like, and I can go down there too and help out and do things. So I'll figure it out. But this guy needs to figure that out, bro. It's you can have money, it's how you go about getting that money.
Was it that when I asked him if he's a Christian, he couldn't answer? When I asked him, is he gay, he said he would be gay for another man, a soccer player. Now you can say it's all jokes and fun and games, but when you can't before the entire world testify whether Jesus is your Lord, that means he's none.
Yeah, that's a problem.
If you can't praise God before the world, that means you're praising the devil before the world. You're denying who the Bible says, if we confess him before men, he will confess us before the Father. But if we deny him before men, he will be denied before the Father. So I want to ask you, is Jesus Christ the Lord of your life?
I'm not a Christian. I respect the Christianity. But
okay, so you're denying Jesus Christ. So if you continue to deny Jesus Christ.
You see how he looked aside and rolled his eyes? He was like, it's like, yeah, bro, I knew you was an unbeliever the way you was talking. You was talking crazy.
You will be denied when you stand before him. And it's totally up to you. I want to let you know something, though. You're denying Jesus Christ because you don't understand your need for the Savior. I respect that everybody has a truth. Doesn't mean I respect what he's saying. I don't respect his beliefs. I don't think his beliefs are accurate or right. But I respect his choice. No, but it doesn't matter what you think. I don't care what you think. I wasn't even talking to you.
I believe
right? You interjected yourself.
No, I don't think. No, listen, if you don't respect what I think, that means you don't believe in God. The Bible says whoever has the Son has the Father. If you don't have the Son, you don't have God. So don't lie to yourself. You have a God that doesn't exist.
Facts. Facts. Man, I love David Lynn's videos. As usual, I always put the original video in the description box. If you guys want to go over to his channel, give his video a like, a comment, and if check out his content. If you like it, go ahead and subscribe. I think he's in Ireland right now. He's hitting everywhere evangelizing. I love it. But in terms of speed, like I said, he's young. He chose the world at this moment because I think he's 19. He's somewhere around that age bracket. But yeah, he chose the world. And I'm not shocked he chose the world, because when I was his age, I chose the world too. It amazes me when I see like the younger kids in my Christian group, the teenagers and like the young college kids, and they're just so into it. And I just be like, man, I be admiring them, because I be like, wow, y'all figured out how to like do it right at a very young age. I kind of wish I went through the same thing. I'm not even gonna lie to you. I wish I figured it out at a young age too, but you live and you learn. That's life. That's life. We all figure it out at some point. But if you guys want to see me react to more videos just like this one, let me know in the comment section down below. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe. Hit that notification bell so you never miss when I drop a video. And to stay up to date, hit that community tabs. I just hit 500 subs. I'm going to do a thank you video, a proper thank you video. But I appreciate every last one of y'all. I'm so happy. I'm so happy. And I don't know how y'all found me or what it was. And y'all was just like, ooh, I'm about to stay here. Thank you. I truly appreciate it. But till next time, you already know who it is. It's Sang.